guys, it's Kakashi here. As you can see, I've got another daily objective, and this time it is, say, battle using any depot. So, once again, not the type of card I'm familiar with at all, but let's see how it goes. First of all,
I've got a
weekly cash, and I've got some tokens that didn't display properly. Blah blah. Okay, that's quite a coincidence. And I've got a depot card. Yeah, not much of a boost, but it's one card, one point of XP, it seems. Okay, just quickly like that, so that it doesn't interfere too much with my chat. Okay, I've got one victory cash slot open. Maybe I get a hacked one. And let's look at the deck. So, let's edit this one over here. Like I said, I'm not familiar with the depots, so I'm gonna upgrade them. Obviously, don't want to upgrade cards willy-nilly, or you know what? It's not required that I upgrade it because of the daily objective. When it's for that type of card, it automatically upgrades it to your turret level. I think level 8. So we've got the Spectre Depot. Let's just look at the wording for this card. Deploy Scarbine Spectres over time that will relentlessly advance to capture hardpoints and destroy enemy turrets. Okay, let's look at the Blast Depot. Deploys Blast Spectres over time and explodes on death. Blast Spectres prioritize enemy turrets. Quite significant damage, 332 for both human and robotic, and it deploys two specters at a time, so that's 664 damage per spawn of these two specters. And if we compare this one to my other depot, the Spectre depot, okay, it doesn't give you any stats on the normal Spectres, that the Carbine Spectres that deploys, but I suppose it's similar to when you spawn the normal burn card for Spectres that I've already got equipped at level 8, which is the same as that the depot is nice long attack range, nice movement speed, hit points is not great, but it is a disposable more or less unit with not very great DPS for humans or robotic, but it's times 3 in this case and times 2 with the depot, I think. And it's got the, let's see, doesn't say how many specters gets the board. Anyways, let's get to the action. So I'm going to replace my beast grunts with that depot, and I'm going to replace the barrage with my blast depot. Okay. It's interesting that the Carbine Spectre depot is 4 energy and the Blast depot is only 5. Okay, so let's look at the rest of the deck. Burn cards. What other burn cards should I use? My average supply is 3.8. Let's keep the Spectre burn card here for now. Let's see if we can do like some kind of swarm deck for fun. Okay, I'm happy with BT. Now I need some cheaper units. Let's try the Smoke Strider is one of my favorites these days, especially because it's at level 10. It's one of my higher level cards, and I think the Reserve Ogre has got a nice spot there. I'm happy with him over there. Just glance quickly, what else can I maybe use? Maybe I should try the Ronin, but he's not very high level. Okay, let's leave the Reserve Ogre for now. Pilots, I'm happy with the Grenadier. I want to put my trusty level 8 Gunner and my trusty Jack Cooper in this fold. Okay, let's try this one. Okay, the supply cost is quite, the average supply is quite high at 3.9. So let's get to a battle. What will my tactics be in this case? I think I'm just gonna play a warm-up game just to see how it plays out, and then I'll make some adjustments to the deck. I'm not really worried about losing trophies at this stage. I'm not pushing too hard for ranking, but yeah, I just want to complete the daily quest and have some fun. The specters that spawn from the depots are robotic, so obviously they're gonna take some heavy damage from anti-robotic units and AoE damage, especially from Scourge Titans. Ion will probably do well against all of these specters, but let's see what happens. Okay, so proof is in the pudding at the end of the day. Let's check what's happening over there. Let's see if I can tank something a bit. I'm gonna put some specters over here to distract that gunner. Put a gunner, my gunner over there. Shoot from up high. Some nice wind up damage. That Grenadier is gonna cause some trouble. And that mine over there. Okay, time to drop my first depot. So I'm not sure what the best spots are to drop depots, but going for that one at this stage. Let's see if this Jack Cooper is gonna AoE down nice. Okay, there's my first specter. Seems like one at a time. Now I'm gonna put this blast depot over there so that the specters run up to that turret and defend this hard. Drop the ogre over there. I should have used the drones instead, but the ogre is going to tank nicely for my specters that will be spawning. As you can see, that gunner just melts, absolutely melts that that reserve ogre of mine. Okay, let's see. The gunner is gonna not last long, actually not bad at all. I actually expected him to do a lot worse. Wow, I can't believe he's taking all of that punishment from that core, from that ion, but I think it's because he may be at the higher ground. I don't know, it doesn't make sense, but it's a possibility. I'm gonna drop smoke bomb over there. Smoke Strider, it's a nice smoke cloud. Okay, nice. Let's capture that hard point. Let's capture that hard point. See, now I need those specters to help capturing hard points, but it's not happening at this stage. Let's drop some specters on those grounds. I think I should have some nice map what do you call it, map presence with their stick, with specters running all over the show, capturing hard points, hopefully. Pop that one over there. Okay. Art Boomer is going to completely rip the specters apart. Pop that one over there. Now, well, it's quite interesting. There's a large amount of specters all over the show. I must say it's quite fun. Let's double up. I like seeing this. This is fun, and I'm sure it has to be a bit intimidating to the enemy. And you know what? That depot has taken down that turret. I'm busy hitting the main turret, and I've won. I'm impressed, eh? It's the first time I'm playing these cards and they are just falling into place. Anyways, what adjustments should I make? I'm thinking maybe the core ogre can be swapped out. Core ogre can be swapped out for the... Ach, sorry, I mean the reserve ogre can be swapped out for the reserve strider, because I've got a lot of anti... the smoke strider is giving me a lot of anti robotic deep damage, so I want some anti bio support with the reserve strider, and all of my victory caches are full, and I'm unlocking this one. Yeah, let's jump into the next game. It's a lot better playing on my Wi-Fi at home. No interruptions or lagging or rejoining or anything funny of that sort. So this is the Boneyard. Okay, Boneyard, this is gonna be interesting, very interesting. It's one of my least favorite maps. I'm sure I can work out some kind of strategy specifically for this map, but I've never really done too much effort at trying to figure out a tactic to have better odds at winning on this map. Anyways, I like it when I use the sentry pilot, the sentry tech, because it is so easy to counter with the gunner. And as a matter of fact, any of the captains as well. The gunner loves to eat them up, as long as he focuses on the captain and not the spawned units that the captain spawns. Then they distract the wind-up of the gunner. Anyways, I need these specters. Okay, they are running to the closest uncapped hard point. It would have been nice if they could have gone to Charlie, but it seems like they're giving me some nice fire support, except they're all running into the mess there with this stupid yellow shield. Gunner taking down a sentry tech, which is what I needed, except there's an enemy gunner taking down my gunner. Okay, let's use this blast depot over there to take out that sentry. I'm gonna use the inspectors to tank the gunner. And there's a Titan over here. What should I use to counter this? Okay, I'm gonna let my turret tank this BT. I'm gonna drop my BT over there to put some damage on the enemy BT and drones for support. Okay, nice. Let's get my gunner to cap Bravo. Put my grenadier to support my BT again. So far, so good. Everything is going my way. I just need to keep on going. Okay, drop another depot. Okay, this sim ninja is definitely causing some trouble for me, but Jack Cooper, like say sim ninja, deals pretty well with him. And here's a nice execution, boom. Okay, let's put a gunner to take out the Atlas. Okay, I've got a bit of trouble over there. Sentry, grenadier. Okay. These inspectors are actually doing a good job at keeping the enemy busy and capping and defending hard points and just tanking damage, and I'm quite happy with the way they disperse themselves. They don't seem to clump up too much in one spot, so that the AOE attack can take out hundreds of them at once. Oh, my BT is still doing a good job over there, but I'm not playing to push towers at this stage. The Jack Cooper over there, he can get his buff. Okay, these specters are all going to get blown up. Boom. They got to keep the BT busy. More drones coming. Okay, they are circling around over there. Yes, these specters are... Interesting. I must say, I'm enjoying these depots. It's a fun style. It's really fun to look at. I must say, the carbine specters, I've been seeing a lot more than the blast specters. I think the, which one's more expensive? The blast specters is 1 point of energy more expensive. It's a rare type card where the Spectre depot is epic. I think purple is epic and blue is rare, and the Spectre depot is 1 point cheaper, which is quite nice. Okay, let's do another battle. Let's see if I can't get a bit more of the blast Spectres in the game. See if I can't get more action out of them. But they seem to have taken out the secondary turret in the one the first game, which is quite good. I'm happy with what happened over there, putting a lot of pressure on the main tower, splitting up the enemies, and it's good at, I think it's good at confusing the enemy, you know, where should he go to deal with what. Okay, that hologram is going to take out these specters. I'm going to put my, come on, I hate it when that happens, specter depot over there. I'm going to put my gunner, yeah, the safe spot. Okay, seems like everything is good plan, except for my camera screwing me around a bit, and the gunner has jumped straight into the trouble over there. Let's get some pressure off by capturing Charlie. Okay, I need my gunner on this sentry. need these drones to tank here at Charlie to keep them busy. Okay, there we go. Come on, come on. Quicker, quicker. Yes. They pulled the grenadier over there. Relieving some pressure. Okay, this is not good. This guy also seems to be playing some kind of Spectre deck. Let's drop this manslaughter. Let's see if my adjustment is actually going to help regarding the taking the pressure off of some of the bio enemies, and it's not working because he's attacking the shield guns. This gunner should take out the opponent, and this game is simply just not going my way. And he's upping. See, and gunner. Let's do this. Smoke slider, smoke cloud. Let's try some of these blast specters. They're probably gonna go straight for the turret instead of the enemy formations where I need them. I really need some caps now. I desperately need some caps. Okay, come on, blast specters, take out that poor ion. Poor ion misfiring as always. Jack Cooper, come on guy, come on boys, I need some. Okay, nice. These specters are doing a good job at defending the hard point. I seriously need something at this stage. I don't know what, but I'm struggling in this game. It seems like I'm maybe catching up a bit. Now I just need to keep an eye on these hard points. Build up some energy. Bank energy for my BT for when it's he spawns his one of his pilots again. Okay, okay. Like this. Over there and over there I should have used. Okay, drones, I need these specters urgently. Come on. Ah, it's too late. Okay, this seems to not be my game at this stage. I really need to get Charlie. I really need to get Charlie. Okay, and it's okay. Oh well, it was a tight game, a bit of a stronger matchup. He did have the ion, ironically, doing AOE damage to two ions, AOE damage and a botic DPS, which is a great counter for the specters. And my reserve strider didn't target the bio units. It target the bio units with the shields, which also cost me. Okay, next game. I'm not gonna make any adjustments now. Let me think. Maybe I should replace my Spectre Bird Guard with a Sentry, which will help with the tanking a bit, because I've got a lot of very light units. I need something tanking. It would be interesting to see what would happen if one of my enemies drop a EMP or a nuke. I think it will just clear the whole map, all the inspectors. But with this last game, I didn't really have any big build-up of specters. They just seemed to... I didn't drop the depots that much. Okay, let's see. Gunner, inspect the captain. Okay, let me see if I can get this drones out here in time. Tank, come on, come on. They didn't aggro anything. So my gunner is going to drop quite quickly. Wow, this guy. And the gunner is focusing on the holo grenade. Great. And my drones is not focusing on the holo grenade as decoy, but making a recovery over here. Jack Cooper is going to rip this gunner apart, and he drops a barrage on me. Nice play. That's also going to do some devastating damage to my Spectres. I'm finding the dropping of the Spectre depot quite interesting. What's the ideal spot to actually deploy them? Obviously you want to keep it out of harm's way. You don't want to drop it at one of the hard points. It doesn't have a lot of health to help tank it or anything of that sort, but yeah, I'm just dropping it as far back as possible, and at this stage I've got four Spectres and they seem to be coming out every 3 seconds or something. It's quite a good rate at spawning. I'm very impressed with that. I wonder if upgrading the card influences the spawn rate or just the stats of the Spectres. So what am I going to do here? Okay, I need something. Okay, gunner, smoke slider. Okay, I'm just going all up, all in. I need my drones. The smoke slider is doing well over there with his smoke screen. Very happy with that AOE damage. And oh, he just didn't survive. Anyways, now the Spectre depot, and this game is going my way. Let's drop this smoke. Let's try the stunner. Boom. Drop some Spectres. They weren't necessary, but got a lot of numbers on them. Okay, that was a pretty easy game. Lots of fun. Enjoyed it. Let's see how many points I've scored with Depo so far. I must say, the more I'm playing the game, the more I'm the easier it is to adapt my decks with new cards as the requirements come through for the daily objectives. Okay, so I've got 120 points to go to complete the daily objective. Let's do this. Okay, I like the deck so far. I forgot to change the Spectres with the sentries, but I like the Spectres. It's I like seeing a big swarm of units, of my units, on the map. I can't remember, I think, is it 3 or is it 5 Spectres that drop with the 3 energy Spectre burn card. Let's keep an eye on that when this match starts again. It's getting a bit late over here. I need to go to bed for work tomorrow. It is Friday tomorrow. Okay, but let's go. Jack Cooper, open it. Let's see what they do. Holo grenade here. I don't have anything to count the holo grenade here with right now. What am I going to do? Jack Cooper is going out of invincibility. That's not good. The holo grenade here. I need to spend these cards to rotate to get something better. I didn't get a good aim to counter the enemy over there. Just didn't work out that great for me. This Spectre really needs to go and kill this Sim Ninja over here. Okay, but it's fine. Sim Ninja is going to be, it's going to cause a lot of trouble for me because of his AoE melee attack. A lot of trouble. I can see that happening. Unless they space themselves quite sufficiently. Okay, Reserve Strider. Let's see. Okay. What's going on over here? What's going on? Let's just hang on for now. I'm gonna put the Spectre Depot on at that spot. Grenadier to take out some. Wow, look at all of these. Okay, it's only three, but wow, they actually survived the Holo Grenadier's grenade, which is really, really good. So I don't want to venture to Alpha while I've got two hard points. I'd rather defend two hard points than try and get greedy and capture one that's a bit out of my reach. This is going to be interesting. Let's see if the Spectre actually manages. Okay, not in time. Okay, drop smokes, starter, nice AoE. Let's do a nice push. BT 7274. I want it. Okay, I need my drones. Take out this 4 ogre as soon as possible. I want some depots on the field. Once again, I didn't play any Blast Spectres this match almost. I can almost take that card out of my deck completely. But anyways, nice, thanks. I think it would be nice to have the Blast Spectre depot in a base rush deck. I think that will work well, especially with those Blast Spectre burn card. Okay, Chan Cooper, let's do these drones to take out the Sim Ninja. The Sim Ninja is ripping apart those Spectres as expected. Do another depot, do more Blast Spectres over there, and get a Canadian to take out these ones. And that's it. Game. That was fun. Okay. Let's see. Did I get the objective now? I think I deployed the depot about 4 times. I haven't worked it out, but I wonder how many points you get per depot that you deploy. Okay, one more match. Let's go. Crash sites for hardboard becomes much easier to capture when the enemy's medium turret is destroyed. Scorch Titans are unlocked by reaching Silver 1. That's another card I've never played. It's is the Scorch, the normal Scorch. I've got the Scorch, which is very nice, and I've got the Thermal Scorch, which was one of my first high level cards. It was fun, but I don't know, it's not my style so much. I think the Thermal Scorch will completely wreck my deck with these low health Spectres running around the map. Okay, let's see, Holo Grenadier, that's a good counter, nothing specifically at this stage. Let's see what happens when I do that. Maybe they end up tanking up the Holo Grenadier's AoE by taking out one Spectre. Let's cap that one over there. Okay, Holo Grenadier over there. Hopefully this Spectre will buy time and tank a bit, Yeah, Hollow Grenadier is gonna cause trouble when they come up like this. But they're doing their job, they're tanking. That's a massive bonus, is all of this health running around. Really helps. Let's put my gunner over there. These sectors are lasting a bit longer than I expected, but I need something there at the top to help cap some points. There's a lot of heat here in the middle. I need to make a plan. What's this guy? Grenadier without a hologram. Hollow Grenadier without the decoy. And nice, something can happen over here. Okay, I need to cap C and I need to cap B. Let's put a Jack Hooper over there. He's not gonna have enough time, especially with the sentry. Okay, that wasn't the smartest move, unless he can cap B. This is not working out. I need something to make a big impact over here. None of these cards itchy. That's right. Blast depot. Let's attack this hard point with spectres. Let's use drones to take out this boss, this score ogre. Okay, that blast deck, blast. Okay, nice. These blast spectres are wrecking this core ogre, which is awesome. They're doing a really great job. Nice. Okay, but I don't have points. I'm not gonna make it. I don't have enough points. This guy's just camping this center hard point like something great. This is not my game. That's it. I should get enough points to complete the daily objective. But it's difficult to see what this guy's overall strategy is. I think he's just using a deck that is strong. He's not playing to complete the objective or anything like that. Anyways, let me drop the depot. Plus 7 points. Okay. 7 points just below my face. That's how much points you get per objective. Per deploying a objective unit. Okay, let's see, I shouldn't. In that case, I should be getting the daily objective done. And it's done. See what I get. Nice. Good chunk of credits. Nice. Tokens. Blast Spectres. Striker. Arc Boomer. Also, used to be one of my favorites until I got Jack Cooper. I would like to give the Arc Boomer another shot, especially with the amp field and rocket grunts. Okay, thanks for watching, guys. It was fun, and the next objective is in 1 hour and 40 minutes. That will be a lunchtime roll for tomorrow.